And welcome back to Assassin's Creed 3, Sequence 12, and I think this will be the final recording. I am not sure, but I think it is the final recording for a few reasons. First of all, you don't want the number 13 in anything you do. I really try to prevent the number 13 in any episode what does it mean? Abergläubisch. Wait, I look at aber. Superstitious, because the number 13 is a superstition, I guess. No, wait. Is the number 13 a superstition? Superstition for being bad luck. So they shouldn't end the game on the numbers 13. And I don't see that it could be even a sequence 14. Sorry that I have to look up so much. But as I said earlier, it's not my native. And even though I have a good grasp on it, I'm still learning and I still don't have every vocabulary. Oh god, the burps are coming. Any vocabulary stored in my fast traffic device called the brain. So yeah, I'm really sorry if I start to stumble, going silent, think about what I'm about to say, and then try to formulate a sentence. That's just how it is. I'm unfortunately not a native. I would love to be one, but I'm not, so yeah. But anyway, so this is probably the final episode what I wanted to say. And in the last one, I ask the very episode, why are the Templars are always coming back even though we smashed them in every single game? And the answer is not really satisfying, but at least the game give coincidentally the answer to this question to me. And that is hilarious. Okay, so let's go on. Sequence 12. Limit regular kills. Okay. I can't one.
Today to remember a man of peerless vision who sought to change the world. And change the world he did. Look around. Even now the British prepare to retreat. Their spirits broken. Their forces splintered. The Patriot leadership shall soon follow. Either into our service or into the ground. And then, my friends, all of this will finally be ours. We have Haytham to thank for this. He and all those others who sacrificed for our cause. But he was not content merely to save the people of America, no. He sought to save those sworn to our destruction. He sought to save the assassins. Aye, it seems a mad thing now. And it cost him his life. The assassins are a cruel and terrible coven. They speak only the language of death. Too late he learned the truth of this. Murdered by his own son. He gave his life as he lived it. In service to a dream we all share. And so we must fight on. We will vanquish our enemies. We will spread our word. And in time, my brothers and sisters, in time, we will have our new world.
Are you going on? No? Okay, then it's time to die. Hello, Charles Lee.
He sent me away. That day, at Fort George. He feared for my safety. I should have stayed. He said there was no danger.
He was wrong.
I will kill you, Connor. This I swear. Not here, though. Not today. No. First, I'll destroy all you hold dear. I'll burn that homestead of yours to the ground and roast the seven heads of your precious founding fathers in its flames. And when I've finished with them, all the rest will burn as well. Your merry band of assassins, the human refuse that lives on your land, your village and its people, all of it gone.
You can try, Charles. But as with all your schemes, this too will end in failure.
Get him on his feet. He will wait. He will watch. And then, when he's seen all his life's work brought to ruin, only then will I allow him to die. Take him away.
Are you serious right now? Why did he do that?
Oh, I hope that was...
What's this fella doing?
Okay.
Show them the pain. Keep them hands.
Come on. Break your defense, get you on the ground, and fuck you up. Limit regular kills. So let's see. Where's Charles Lee? Is that Charles Lee? No. They are all golden targets? They said I have to limit regular kills. What about assassin kills? Covered escort, lure, ambush, marksman.
Where is Charles Lee gone?
The harbor. To catch a ferry.
Now I know why I don't like him that much. I'm missing one of the crucial things in the whole series. Requiesta in pace. Rest in peace. I'm missing this. That he pays his respect in this manner. So, yeah, maybe that's the reason. He pays his respect in some way, but not the way I'm intended. Or I think should be intended. Anyway. Oh, hi. Okay, so you are a thing that's happening. You know what I'm doing? I just call my bodyguards. Oh,
good
shit.
To see you.
Come on, attack them. I will not fight. You can fight on your own. You are assassins after all. Didn't even need it to... Can I board the ship? No, I have to swim the whole way? Okay. I thought I had to do something different, but yeah. So I have to get the ferry. I wonder how they will follow me. I mean my assassins. I mean they are all available again, but I probably should change them to assassin to marksman. Marksman is the most reliable. And they are all available again. So in theory they should just randomly appear on the ferry. The bad thing is, I always call every single assassin with only one call. Oh, okay, they are away. Wait, I have to limit what kind of kills? Limit regular kills. What are even regular kills? So I have to get up there. The question is how? I think on the far other side of the ship is a possibility for me to go aboard. To go all through those assholes. Can I go maybe sideways? No. Oh, hi. Oh, don't tell me you can't go. Oh, good, you can. So, what I'm thinking is,
you there. Stop. Oh, come back here, you coward. Stop.
What now? Why did the... Oh. Oh, fucking course.
I believe these men meet the requirements. You believe incorrectly. They're sick and weak. We're looking to build an army, not fill an almshouse. It would take months to get them into fighting shape. We don't have the time.
No, please. We'll do anything you want. Anything. Only take us with you.
Quiet, whelp! Your merchandise is useless to us. Perhaps we should discuss this back in my cabin.
Great. So I already did more kills than I should have, and I didn't want it to drop that low. Is this a regular kill? Yep, it counts as a regular kill. Great. I actually want to have full synchronization, but if I can't handle it, then I can't handle it. Okay, what's the next way I have to go? Do I really have to observe them? Oh yeah, I have to find out where Charles Lee is. Where on this big, big ship?
Sorry to have disappointed. As you should be. For us to have come all this way for nothing. Tell me now why I shouldn't have you thrown into the sea.
No need to be rash. Only give me a little more time. I'll scour the other ships if I must. I'm certain there are prisoners who will meet your needs.
Very well. You have 2 days.
Thank you.
Present yourself to the Green Dragon Tavern in Boston with the men you've chosen. We shall meet you there along with our master.
Okay, escape Jersey without entering into open conflict. Wait, what? Escape Jersey without entering into kill the MHS Jersey, Captain. Really? Can I kill him from up here, maybe? No? I would really like to do that, but he's running away like a coward. I'm gone. Oh hell no, don't tell me this was the whole mission. This was not the whole sequence, was it? No, it wasn't. Okay. Where to go now? What's the next? Okay, next I have to go to Boston. Okay, so I see you then in Boston. And I'm back. Okay, so let's see what this next thing is all about.
Need something, darling?
No.
Oh, rude.
Can I help you?
You know you can.
Pardon? Oh!
I do not like having my time wasted.
Stop that! Don't make me call the guards!
Make a sound and you die.
What do you want? He's in the harbor, at the Long Pier, most likely. We heard what happened at the parade. Charles got all nervous. Said he was leaving the country. I thought it was overreacting. It's not. No.
Thank you.
Nice one. Really nice one. So find Lee near the harbor. Oh, I can't fast travel. So yeah, let's go by horse. I just steal this random horse that standeth white at the entrance. Nobody suspects a thing. They are all unaware of me. Oh, this is Star Wars, okay. I just thought about what am I even humming there? But yeah, it's Star Wars. Definitely Star Wars. Chase an... No, I don't want to chase an almanac page. Okay, Charles Lee should be somewhere here. Use the eagle vision to look for a golden target. This looks like a golden target. There he is. Can I really just end it right here and there? No, of course not. Why? This is not even remotely assassin-like. An assassin is supposed to sneak up on his prey and not blindly run into him. Whoa. Why? What? Can you run me by that one more time? I went as fast as I could and I couldn't keep up with this little fuckhead? Oh no, don't tell me you're doing this right now with me. Ah, how am I supposed to even do that? Ha, you missed me! Ah, this is freaking hard. Do not shove anyone doing the chase. No! You can't go in there, there's been an exit. Wait. I'm died! For fire damage. No, don't tell me I have to do all this again. Please tell me there was a checkpoint. Oh, you bitch! I have to do all of this again? Oh.
Yes. Keep at them. Damn blockers. Send them all in boxing.
Reduce distance. I fucking noticed.
You can't go in there.
There's been an accident.
Come on, one. Fucking kidding me! What bullshit is that? Why did he fall down? What? Okay, let's see this bullshit again in instant replay. Okay, I'm moving up here. Then I want to... Oh, okay. So this is falling apart. I know that, so I should be able to... Why? Oh. Wait, what? How? How? Where? When am I supposed to get anywhere with this? What now? What do you want from me? What is life right now? What is with these controls? Why are they sucking all of a sudden? Okay, next go. Next go. Let's see what this time my fail was. So, he is going through there. So, where am I supposed to go now? I think down here? Come on, jump! Come on! Can you jump? Jump, you little fucker! No! Not again! I don't even know where to go! Okay, last time I do this. So, first of all, I have to fuck this up. Second of all, kill him by shooting him straight in the face. Okay, this is the next step. Because this is the first time I had to look up what to do. Because I'm so blinded of rage right now that I couldn't figure out what to do. I couldn't see the obvious. And you will all give me a big old face palm if you see how obvious it was where to go. Because if this breaks down, I just have to jump over this little ledge here. And then just have to go here.
Hey,
And I fucked up. Hey, this is my second big face palm in the face I will get from you guys. So, break down. Go over here. And the thing I didn't saw initially was that I just had to slide under it. There was a slidey slide. A slidey slidey slide. Oh no 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 no. Come on! One! Why are you staying there?
You put us down, we rise again. You end one plot, we forge another. You try so hard, but it always ends the same. Those who know you think you mad, and this is why. Even those men you sought to save have turned their backs on you. Yet you fight. You resist. Why?
Because no one else will.
Connor dies? No, he don't die. Otherwise, there would be no after game. Wait, can you run me by that one more time? Still resist, because no one else will. So hopefully Lee is dead now? They didn't even give me the satisfaction to press the X button.
Rough night, was it? He headed inland, took a ferry up the Charles River.
I will need passage as well.
Of course. Only say the word.
I have the feeling there will be a sequence 13? No, no sequence complete yet. Oh, this is so... I always broke something. Almost broke some... Where the fuck am I? I never was here. I never liberated that. And I'm still wounded. Oh, I can't move any slower right now. I can't move faster. If I try to run, he's going even slower. How are you supposed to do anything in this damn it, the word was already mentioned. In this condition, yeah. There will be no magic spoo to heal you up. Which heal you up? How is he still alive?
Oh,
He could just take the dagger and ram it into you. Six months later, so he recovered.
Why would they leave this behind?
Because you need it.
Ah, long have we waited for you to return. You have done as we asked. You have succeeded.
No, I have failed. My people are gone. Chased out by those who I thought would protect them.
It is a trade, a sacrifice, and not in vain. For you have found it.
This?
Now you must hide it, where none shall think to look. And then in time, what once was shall be again.
I do not understand.
Nor need you. Only do as we ask. Then you may do as you wish.
But what of my people?
You have saved this place, as was your people's purpose, and that matters most.
It is not enough.
It will never be enough. You strive for that which does not exist. Still, you have made a difference, and you will do so again. Remember, you must hide the amulet where none might find it.
And I know exactly where this is. It's the very place we are in, and his father couldn't open it before, but I think he can somehow open it. Wait, you won't just dig a hole and put it in, do you? I don't like his new hairstyle as well.
Thank you.
Here lies the body of Connor Davenport.
Huh?
I thought 7 years? Oh, that's why he gave him this name. Of course, a grave is always a good place to hide an ancient amulet. And nobody in 300 years ever thought about digging this place up. The sum of truth. Sequence 12 completed.
I know where the key is.
Then let's go!
Davenport, the old man, and I can the old oh, okay, can't read it.
Guess this is it.
We're right behind you.
Okay, so I don't need a power source in here? Okay, let's go, cool. Let's walk patiently, cool, in line of all our assassin brothers. Towards the entrance. Towards the final climax. Towards the end of which I will finally get a really, really good conclusion about what this world is all about. And if we can save it, and most of all, if this will have a good ending. If Assassin's Creed and all the Desmond path comes together to a satisfying conclusion, and not just some gibberish bullshit.
Moment of truth.
Yes. Are you all following me? What? Oh, pretty. Even though there's not even much to see, but just the way the camera was.
Yes. Come. Here. At last.
You know our story now, of how we tried, of how we failed, all our hopes extinguished, save one, your touch, a spark to save the world.
Wait! Do not touch the pedestal!
Minerva?
You! But how? You left! You destroyed the device!
Did you think there was only one?
What the hell is going on here?
You must not free her.
Free her?
Juno dwells within these walls, awaiting release. I will explain. While we worked to save the world, she sought instead to conquer it. She used our machines to set her plans in motion. Divination through numbers. There is a pattern to existence. To comprehend the calculations is to tame time. This was my focus. And so I built the eye to aid us. But she turned it towards her own ends. When we discovered her treachery, we put a stop to it. And then we left. But first we called to you, that you might try again. We thought it would be safe with her gone. Now I see we were deceived. She survived, she endured, and then she began to work. For centuries, Tinia and I walked the world, hoping to rekindle the spark of civilization. We shared what we knew as best we could. We were not the only ones, but for all the power we wrought, still death would claim us. But before it did, I would have one last look to know if we had succeeded.
That's how you're here now?
I had hoped you might find this place and finish our work. But it is too late. You and the Templars have squabbled over our refuse. You have wasted centuries, and so you have lost your chance. You cannot hope to stop the end now, Desmond. Only to survive.
She's lying!
Only touch the pedestal and the world will be saved. Better the world burn than she be loosed upon it.
Is that so? Show him then.
But he will not understand. It is complicated. It is...
Show me.
What?
If you heed Minerva, the sun will have its way. The ground will crack and spit fire into the skies. All the world will burn. But this does not end the world, merely heralds its arrival. Darkness follows. Then you emerge, resolving to lay a foundation that such a tragedy does not befall the world again. You will become a symbol to those who survive. Hope, knowledge, determination. You will inspire them to rebuild, to thrive once more. And as the world heals, so too will humanity. But you are just a man, frail and mortal. You pass from the world, leaving behind only a memory. A legacy. You will be remembered first as a hero, later as a legend, and in time, as a god. It is the cruelest fate to have written words that meant well and see them made wicked and unwise. What was meant to encourage life, used instead to justify taking it. And so now you see that what was shall be again. So tell me, how is this better?
She would sacrifice you, sacrifice the world, for no other reason than to deny me vindication. They will enslave your kind, Desmond. Is this not why you fight? Is this not why you came here? To ensure more than just your race's future, but its freedom?
What future? What freedom? Billions dead and the whole cycle begun anew? This world has known nothing but heartache and horror since we left it.
Our gift to them, and you'd see it all returned.
Enough!
You must not do this.
Whatever Juno's planning, however terrible it might seem today, we'll find a way to stop it. But the alternative, what you want, there's no hope there.
If you free her, you'll be destroyed.
It will happen in an instant. There will be no pain.
You mustn't.
It's done, Minerva. The decision's made.
Then the consequences of this mistake are yours to live and die with.
You need to go. All of you. Now. Get as far away from here as you can.
Come with us! We'll find another way!
There isn't time.
Son.
You know it's true. It's already started. I need to do this now. So go. Go!
What? What? I am confused as hell. Am I the only one here?
Some sort of global aurora borealis. Never seen anything like this before. Eyewitnesses describe electrical storms and erratic displays of unusual weather. Residents are being asked to remain inside and wait for... Geological surveys are now reporting seismic activity throughout the Ring of Fire. Northeastern Canada is said to be experiencing the largest... on record. Satellites and transformers are failing as the flare increases in intensity. Worldwide reports of blackouts and seems to be receding. Residual seismic and volcanic activity is being reported, but nothing approaching earlier levels. Obviously, it'll be a while before experts are able to assess the full extent of the damage caused by today's events. But it appears the worst is behind us. We'll be sure to bring you more as this story develops.
It is done. The world is saved. You played your part well, Desmond. But now... now it's time that I play mine.
What?
So she looked in the future and saw that... they got... Did I get this right? So the one alternative would be Desmond and his friends would survive. He would have arisen humanity anew, was a great leader to get them all in harmony. And then, after his death, some stupid assholes, aka the Templar, would twist his words around and just... do all the horror and all the terrorizing all over again as it happened before. So, there was Minerva? I don't know, the one with the long hair? Said she can save the world? And the one with the crown-sized thing said that he shouldn't do it. So that they at least would survive this and not free her. And because Desmond thought this vision is not a good foreseeing, cause everything will turn back to anarchy and tyranny. No, anarchy is the wrong word. To tyranny and stuff like that. There's no real hope because the future will just repeat itself. So he decided to get this long-haired goddess, whatever, to free her and in the same process save the planet as it is now, which is still a piece of shit, more or less. An exaggerated piece of shit. We have still hopes that we can save this mess, but it grows thinner and thinner. And Minerva is now free and has her own scheme to do something horrible in the game. In the world. And will we see the conclusion to this? Will there be an explanation what she has planned? What will happen? She said... the one with the crown said that she might rule... that she might rule the world? I know for a fact that those credits will go for 20 minutes. For literal 20 minutes. So, I will just be here babbling for 20 minutes or so and try to get a final conclusion out of this. And I hope that in the end of this, that in the very end of this, I will get an answer. I read about that the ending that there is something more to come after the credits that you can skip. You can skip the credits. You could skip almost everything in the game except for the credits. And yeah, and it seems that the final thing is not satisfying. And so far, I feel betrayed. I feel like fucked over. I liked Assassin's Creed 1, even though it was repetitive as hell. I liked Assassin's Creed 2, because Ezio was such a great, great assassin, and the story inside it, it was Italy, wasn't it? Inside Italy was great, the real-life story was great, more or less. Yeah, it was kind of great, and after that, in Brotherhood? Yeah, I think in Brotherhood, there we was in Rome. That was an awesome story, and even the bits and bytes of the real-world connections were great implemented, and the ending of this was just... And, yeah, they answered... And in Revelations, his brain got busted around and they had to find more, and we could play more with Ezio in a foreign land. And there were more discoveries. We found out more about Altair. We found out more about Ezio himself and what happened. Where the next Apple of Eden was. Where the next location was they had to go. And after that, they traveled to Fallens. And then they landed there. And a lot of questions that were unanswered in Revelations and Brotherhood was why he killed Lucy. So the blonde girl, he stabbed her in the stomach. And it was also... There were a lot of things explained. And it seems I haven't kept enough attention to who those who came beyond were. I know one of them were called Minerva, the other one I forgot already. There were a lot of names and I can't keep all the names in my head. So yeah. But anyway, this is infuriating. This is just... And the last sequence was a bitch. It was really a bitch. You were in the heat of it. You felt rushed after failing so many times, and it seems you could really saw where to go and whatnot. And yeah, I was maybe stupid. I was blinded after two fail attempts by pure rage, so I couldn't get my head around where to go and how to run. And now I get this ending. This, okay, they saved the world. This is the premise which all the parts of Assassin's Creed were aiming to. They were aiming to save the planet from the solar eruption which was caused by the sun. And they did it. But what happens now to the world? What will happen now after we freed the other... one that came before, the long-haired one, the one who said to play her part now. If the other one, the one with the crown, she seems to have survived somehow too. So why is she not trying to stop her? Why is she able to act and try to take over the world now, as it seems, and not the other one? Why does she can't do anything? Does she need a body? Will she just live in the cyberspace and is technically just a virus that is unpredictable and stuff? I really don't know what to get out of this. I'm just highly confused and I can't form proper sentences to express my confusion on this. This is a very, very, very unsatisfying ending so far. Maybe it's just me, maybe it's just because I can't understand it as I should understand it. Okay, maybe I should give my thoughts on the game itself. So the things I disliked most was, I guess, the traveling system. The fighting system was quite decent, but still kind of flawed and rage-inducing at some points. But it was still not as bad as I anticipated. The thing that I disliked most was that it wasn't that the double kill animations were not properly explained how to execute them. I would have loved to do way more of them than I had in the game. What I still liked about the game? The story from Connor itself was good. I really liked the story and the pacing of it. So it was all in all the Connor story was kind of solid. It was fun in most In most situations it was really good told. The voice actors were good as always, as far as I can judge it, but the voice acting was great. It seems that the game had a lot of glitches. Sometimes it happened that I stuck in thin air and the area wouldn't load. It happened that the markers just vanished and disappeared. What I also disliked was that the how was it called? Where you synchronize yourself, so to get vision on the map, that they were not fast travel points, and that they kinda lost its purpose more or less. And that the map was not fully revealed like in the other installments after you climbed them. You can still reveal pieces of the map because not every location has enough eagle vision points. Eagle vision points? Eagle sightseeing points, I just call them now, to uncover the whole map. The homestead was a cool story in itself. So I could have done an own let's play only upon the homestead missions, but I purposely only put the main missions in there cause it would just blow the whole thing up. It would have brought up way too many episodes, so I just left it at that. And yeah, for you having a opportunity to play it for yourself and see what it is all about, because it would have got boring for you just to watch it, to watch all these things. And as I said before, I'm only here for showing you an adventure, to having an adventure with you all together, to grasp through all this in a really pacing manner and a wheeling heating manner, because of all the fucking raging I did in the few episodes this has. So all in all, we have 12 action-packed episodes. Hopefully most of it are action-packed, others well, maybe not. But yeah, I like the game so far. It was a solid game, but the final conclusion and the ending of Assassin's Creed 3, they were not satisfying. They were not satisfying at all. And I really wonder what will happen in Black Flag. What will be the next thing that happens in Black Flag? What is the next story of Black Flag? What will be the story in Black Flag? And I don't mean only the story inside the Animus Black Flag. I mean outside the story in the real world. Because there has to be a person who goes into the Animus to synchronize memories for a purpose. And in Unity, I felt like there seems to be a purpose in Unity, but I already forgot what that purpose was. I really just forgot what the purpose was in Unity. Well, I think I played Unity a year ago, so it's quite natural to forget it, but they wanted to get the player, so we who are in front of the TV, they wanted to introduce our own history, our own personality into the game. So we had no lines to talk, so they only talked to us in messages when they could reach the Templar, and that we jacked into Abstergo with a VR system to relive memories from the past, and the assassins just hijacked us and tried to get Abstergo away from us so that we can find the things they needed. So Abstergo put in Unity all up this whole stuff to get from all the people all over the world to get the information they wanted to find more pieces of Eden, I guess, and to rule the world still. So I don't know how this all connects in any way. I don't know how this all connects. So, yeah. So Unity, with the ending of Assassin's Creed 3, Unity just don't make any sense anymore. Because if the ending of Assassin's Creed 3 is the ending of humankind in some way because of the long-haired who came before, who will kind of tyranny the world, will kind of try to wane the world. I don't know if I actually do it right. It's just... This is just a blow, and not a mind blow, it's a blow in a bad way, in a really, really bad way. And I have no idea, and I struggle so hard recently with my English. Normally I could put out sentence over sentence about the greatest things, but right now my mind gets all blank, and it feels like I know the vocabulary, but I just can't grasp it. I can't formulate proper sentences, and this enrages me so much, and I think my mind just shuts down. It just shuts down really, really hard right now. So I guess I go silent now. I'm kind of tired. I don't even know why I'm so tired right now. But all in all, the game itself was kind of good. The gameplay was kind of solid, even though it was still not really perfect. And yeah, I don't know. My final verdict is, it could have been better. It could have been way better. But I think they just tried to show off some new visuals, because this ought to be the first next-gen game. But next-gen varies in its definition. Next-gen doesn't always mean to have the best graphics. I guess next gen means to have unique mechanics, unique gameplays, unique storytelling, or yeah, it can be all of that. I mean, even indie games can be more or less next gen. Well, but I guess next gen seems to be all about visuals and not about quality anymore these days. Okay, I think I go silent now. I close my eyes for a little bit and just wait for the credits to end. I wait for the credits to end. It's just water, everyone. This looks kind of cool. Everything looks kind of funny in a green screen. Look here, the water is not the water, but the glass is reflecting the blackness, so it isn't fully grown. And if I show the reflection is gone, these are black. It's kind of funny. Well, I guess it's time for some Dokkan battle. Oh, is this the ending? Are those the ending of the credits? Oh. Okay, what's happening now? It's over for now. What? Wow, I don't need the homestead upgrade anymore because the game is over. This is all? No final conclusions? No nothing? Wait. There's something. There's still a main mission here. There. How can I? I'm as close as I can get so far.
Most wonderful stews, especially when harvest time is just done and everything is still fresh.
Okay, let's go there. There's still something going on. Session end. Charles Lee is dead, but Connor realizes his work is far from done. Contacted by the first civilization, he has buried the amulet where only Desmond will find it. Well, no shit. Come on. Why can't you move faster? Not district liberated. I know that I liberated it. It's all liberated by now. Evacuation Day. Epilogue.
America has no need for
Send
your services, gentlemen.
Send them back to Britain in a box. Death to the oppressors!
Cut them down!
Slave sale. Okay, now I have to go to the frontier for some reason. Okay, show me where I need to go now. I want to wrap it all up in this episode. Because this has to be the final one. Because I want it to be like that. Wait. Oh! Wow.
If you're hungry, I've extra.
No, thank you. Where is everyone?
Gone west. Been a while since they left. Seems some fella from New York was granted the land by Congress.
What?
Seeing it happen more and more. Government says they don't take land that's already owned, but...
How could this have happened?
We're on our own now. No more merry English parts and labor. Which means we gotta go at it ourselves. Gotta pay for it too. Selling land is quick and easy. Not quite so nasty as taxes. And since some say they're what started the old war, ain't no rush to bring 'em back. Clever men, these new leaders of ours. They know not to push it just yet. Too soon for taxes. Too British.
Thank you.
Be safe.
Okay, where's the next marker? Next marker is in Boston. Okay, this is just an overall... Wait, what was that?
So I've planted two of our pivots. Not easy for my end, believe you me. But there they are. You can see those two activating a buried one. Kinda. If you drop the third one we have, the buried pivot's precise location should resolve. Then go gather the hex cipher, rinse, and repeat. If you get a chance, I'd love to see Franklin's glass harmonica in person. Just a side note. Have fun.
Wait, what? Wait, what?
All right, we're up and running. This code is hacked to all hell. Nicely hacked, but hacked. The worm found three pivots before failing, so we've got those. You need to locate the remaining pivots on your own from inside. The three we've got will triangulate the rest. It's a sweet bit of hacking on my part, if I dare say. Each pivot detects the others in proximity. There should be 12 total. Everyone you find is supposed to produce a hex cipher, and that's what we're after. Once you find them all, we'll sequence the code, package the data, and Bob's your uncle. Now don't putz around too much in revolutionary America. I know it's tempting.
What the fuck are you on about? Session end. Charles Lee is dead. Has been buried. Eh? What do you want from... What is this bullshit? Season changer hack unlocked. Newspaper. Any more sinking? View details of pivot within. Wait, notification center, resume, quit. Animus database, DNA tracker. Animus training center. Wait, I can't even leave the Animus anymore. Statue about manual, Desmond Miles, Sean. Okay. This is something. This is something really disappointing. This game. This game is the most disappointing installment of the Assassin's 3 franchise for its story. And I particularly say this because of the ending. I don't dig the ending. I don't understand the ending. It just all seemed to went to shit. It seems the world is done for. Even though it is saved. But the long haired from the first civilization will take over the world and will just waste her own way in it, and everything's went to shit. That's basically what I'm getting out of this. This is the most disappointing thing so far. And this is just... Wow. Really, Ubisoft? Really? Who wrote this script? Who wrote this? I want a better ending. I want a final conclusion. I at least want a semi-happy ending. I would already be fine with a semi-happy ending. But this ending just leads open to one way. Total annihilation in a bad way. Not through the sun, but through this AI that was trapped inside a magic glowing ball. And we released it by killing Desmond, which was killed by touching it and... released her with a final spark, and even for him, everything went to shit. His whole tribe was chased out of the country, like it was in history. I give you that, in history, all this went to shit as well. But still, this is just... And now you want to make me some tracking shit? Wait, I have to look up what this means. Come on. We have the time, we have the technology. I'm looking up those tracking pits. Let's see what this tracking points is all about. AC3 tracking. Wait, what? No, I don't want this tracking. Wait. What do I have to find? They wanted me to find something stupid. Wait, how is it? Oh, there. Animus sinking and pivot. What is this about? pivot mission. Yeah, let's see what this shit is all about. Our special collectibles and unlock once you beat the main story and are connected to the internet. Pivot points unlock cheats in the Animus. The locations for pivot points are chosen randomly, selecting spots where another player has placed a point. That means that where you place the pivot will affect the location of them in someone else's game. Every person's locations will be different, but you can use the points that you have collected to help narrow your search further. So the Summon Winter, no reload time. Ninja guard detection and investigation is turned off. So it's basically just a built-in cheat engine. There you have it. Okay, great. I'm gonna leave this episode here. Even though you probably are disappointed as me at this point. But I hope you enjoyed my raging and my commenting, even though it was mostly I don't know how to pronounce it right now. And my ranting and all that funny stuff that happened in this. Not the game itself. I don't tell you that I couldn't enjoy the ending of the game here. I couldn't enjoy the very ending of the game. I feel betrayed by Ubisoft for the very first time. This ending was a piece of crap. It was unsatisfying on so many different levels. So, yeah, I'm ending this right here, right now. I hope I will see you around on my channel. There are a lot of other Let's Plays I did. And they were so much better. And I'm really sorry that this installment of Assassin's Creed is so disappointing. Maybe it's only in my opinion. Maybe I just don't get it. Maybe I just don't get the bigger picture. Please, please enlighten me. I'm begging you, enlighten me. Explain me what this is all about. If you really want to help me explain it, in the comments down below, what is your final opinion about this? Even though I think it's scattered all over the internet, but I really don't want to invest any more time in this. So, yeah. I hope I will see you around. As I said, there are a lot of lovely stories I have already uploaded. For instance, one of my very first Let's Plays. Well, it wasn't my very first Let's Play, but it was one of my early, the Let's Play of my early day, Child of Light. Oh, it was a great story. I enjoyed every minute of it. It was linear, but the story was good. The pacing was good. The difficulty was good. There were so many things done right in this game. And another example is Fortune Summoner was, again, a raging game, and it has, and the ending wasn't that perfect, but the ending of Fortune Summoner was at least 5, if not 6 times better than this ending, even though it was only one game and not 4 installments to get finally to the final conclusion. And yeah, I think those are more or less all my recommendations for now. I will hopefully see you in the next Let's Play I'm doing. Stay tuned for that.